Okay, so good morning all of you. So today I want to discuss about one of the very important topics of machine design. The topic is critical sections and critical points. The definition of the critical section is like this. Critical section is the section where stress developed is maximum, and critical section is the section where area of cross section is minimum. So I want to explain about the critical section with the help of a figure here. For example, I am taking an example here. There is a stepped shaft here. Stepped shaft is having three different cross sections, A1, A2, A3. So if this is subjected to a load of P, so anybody can say that if at all this member fails, it will fail at A2, because on the A2, the stress developed sigma 2 is P by A2. So this sigma 2 is the maximum stress. It is maximum because the area of cross section is minimum. So we can say it this way: critical section is the section where area of cross section is minimum and stress developed is maximum. So if you look at the point, critical point is the point on the critical section where stress developed is maximum. So I want to explain about the critical sections and critical points by taking some standard cases here. The importance of the critical section and critical point is, before ever we design any component, first we have to identify the critical sections and critical points. If the critical sections are taken care, the design will be safe. If at all that component fails, it definitely fails at the critical section, it definitely fails at the critical point. The failure begins from the critical point, it definitely fails at the critical section. That's the reason it's very important that we have to identify the critical sections and critical points in all the practical cases. So first let me take different examples here and we try to identify the critical sections and critical points. Now first let me begin with a beam subjected to axial loading. I am taking a beam having uniform cross section. So this is subjected to a load of P, which is an axial load. The hallmark of the axial load is, when the area of cross section is uniform, the stress developed inside is uniform throughout the section. So here the area of cross section is same throughout. So stress is equal to tensile stress, it is P by A. This stress is uniform throughout the member. For example, if I take one section here, the stress developed on this section is sigma T. If I take another section here, the same amount of stress is developed. If I take any normal section, on every normal section the stress developed is sigma T only. So if we try to identify the critical sections here, first thing we have to see is, we have to look at the area. Second thing is, we have to look at the stress. So if we look at the area wise all the sections are having same area. So we cannot identify according to the area now. If you look at the stress here, even the stress wise also all the sections are bearing the same amount of stress. So area wise they are all same. Even stress wise also they are all same. If that is the case, every section is a critical section here. All these sections are critical sections here. Now let me come into the critical point. Critical point is the point on the critical section. I am taking one critical section here. So on this critical section, at each and every point, it may be a point at the center, it may be point on the circumference, it may be a point inside anywhere. At each and every point, the stress developed is sigma T only. If this is the case, all the points are supposed to be the critical points here. So all the points on every cross section is a critical point. Then every point in this particular beam is a critical point. So here you won't appreciate this concept of critical sections and critical points much. If we move to the second case, you will understand this critical sections and critical points very clearly. So let me move on to this second case now. Variable bending moment. A component is subjected to variable bending moment. I am taking a cantilever beam subjected to a shear force, let it be F, acting at the free end. This force is at a distance of L. So if you see the bending moment diagram here, the bending moment diagram is like this. So here the bending moment is maximum. Here the bending moment is zero. This is called variable bending moment because the bending moment changes from zero to maximum value from this particular length, over this length. So here the bending moment is zero, here the bending moment is maximum. So bending stress is sigma b is equal to m by z. So this is the formula for the bending stress. So this is the bending moment and this is the section modulus. So if we try to identify the critical sections, first we have to look at the area. Area wise, all the sections are having same area. So area wise, we cannot locate this. If you look at the stress here, here the bending moment is zero, naturally bending stress will also be zero here. So as the area of cross section is same, the section modulus is same. So for a constant section modulus, bending stress is proportional to bending moment. So here the bending moment is zero, bending stress is zero. Here the bending moment is maximum, bending stress is also maximum. So this is the only section where stress is maximum. Then you can say that this section is the only critical section in this particular member. It is the critical section. Okay, one critical section. Now let us identify the critical points here. If I take this critical section here, so this is the critical section I am talking about. So if we see the stress distribution here, bending stress distribution is like this. So this member is subjected to hogging moment. Naturally the beam bends like this. And all the upper fibers are subjected to tensile stress. Lower fibers are subjected to compressive stress. So here this is tensile stress. So this is sigma T max. And here this is compressive stress. This is sigma C max. And at the neutral axis, the stress is zero. That means if you take any point on the neutral axis, the stress is zero here. So if you move away from the neutral axis, the stress keeps on increasing. If you move to this outermost point, here the stress is maximum, sigma T maximum. Here also the bottommost point, the stress is sigma C max. So that means in this critical section, the topmost point and the bottommost points, these two points are the critical points. That means one critical section is here and two critical points are here. So if at all this beam fails, definitely the failure begins somewhere here and definitely it fails here. So if you take care of this particular section, your entire beam is safe. Now let me move on to the third case. So this is the concentrated bending moment. Concentrated bending moment means the beam is subjected to an applied bending moment or concentrated bending moment like this. It's not a moment produced because of a shear force, it's a moment directly applied. It's concentrated. So if you look at the bending moment diagram for this, the bending moment diagram is like this. That means the bending moment is M here. The same M continues here. The bending moment is constant throughout the length. So this is the bending moment diagram. And bending stress formula is sigma B is M by Z. And area of cross section is same. That means Z is same. So sigma B is proportional to M. So here the bending moment is M. Even the bending stress is sigma B. Here also the bending stress is sigma B. Here also the bending stress is sigma B. If you look at each and every section, the area of cross section is same, and even the stress is also same. That means every section is a critical section here. And if you look at the critical points here, I already explained about this one. When it is subjected to a bending moment, the topmost points and the bottommost points are the critical points. So this is a hogging moment, naturally it bends like this. So every point, every topmost point and every bottommost point, they are all critical points. And all these sections, they are critical sections. So every section is a critical section, and all the topmost and bottommost points are the critical points. Now let me move on to the fourth case, twisting moment. So here also I am taking a beam having uniform cross section. So this is subjected to a twisting moment of T at the free end, let it be. So if this beam is subjected to a twisting moment at the free end, the twisting moment diagram will be like this. Let it be twisting moment diagram, TMD. So that means the twisting moment is T here, it is same throughout the length, it is T here. So because of the twisting moment, the stress developed is torsional shear stress. This is T by ZP. So this is the twisting moment and this is the polar section modulus. As the area of cross section is same throughout, even the polar section modulus is also same. For a constant polar section modulus, tau s is proportional to T. So here the T is constant throughout the member, that means the tau s is also constant. Torsional shear stress. So this torsional shear stress is constant throughout the member, That means every section is a critical section because area of cross section is same and stress developed is also same. Now let us analyze the critical points here. For example, if we take a critical section like this, so if you look at the stress distribution, torsional shear stress distribution, it's like this. So that means at the center the torsional shear stress is zero. As you move away from the center, at the outermost point or on the point on the circumference, the torsional shear stress is maximum. So here the torsional shear stress is maximum. Here this is maximum. So that means every section is a critical section and every point on the circumference of the beam, it's not topmost and bottommost, every point on the circumference of this beam, they are all critical points. So I want to conclude this. My conclusion is this. When a beam with uniform cross section is subjected to axial loading, every section is a critical section and every point on this beam is a critical point. When you come to the second case, when the beam is subjected to variable bending moment, there will be only one critical section, that is the section at the fixed support, and there will be only two points that are the critical points. Those points are topmost point and bottommost points. When the beam is subjected to concentrated bending moment, every section is a critical section and all the topmost and bottommost points, they are the critical points. When you come to the final case, when the beam is subjected to twisting moment, every section is a critical section and all the points on the circumference, They are all critical points. So we'll be coming across the cases where a component is subjected to combination of these loads. So in my next class, I'll be discussing about a component subjected to axial load, a component subjected to variable bending moment, a component subjected to concentrated bending moment, and also twisting moment. All the four cases combined together, I'll discuss about the critical sections and critical points in my next class. Thank you.